Garrick's Reavers are a brutal warband of murderers who stalk the streets of Shadespire looking to take skulls for corn. In this video, we're going to show you how to paint them using Garrick Gorebeard himself as our example, and by following along with all the methods and techniques we're going to show you, you'll be able to paint the entire warband. So without further ado, let's get started. The first step of painting your miniatures is to undercoat them, and for these miniatures I recommend you use Mechanicus Standard Grey Spray, which you can see is exactly what I've done with my model here. This colour is a fantastic starting point for all the colours that we're going to be using, and for the first colours, well, we need to paint in the skin first of all. For Garrick's skin tone we need Bugman's Glow for our base colour, and as always remember to shake all your paints before you use each colour. Now I'm going to be applying this using a medium base brush, which is a good size brush for the kind of detail that we want to do here, and what you need to do is just get some of this paint onto your brush then put it onto your palette like this, because having it on a palette allows you to thin it down with a little bit of water. It's very important you do this, because doing so just means the paint goes a little bit further and dries smoother as well. So you want to get it to about that sort of mix before you start to apply it. And when you're ready, all you've got to do is start applying this to all the skin. Now for this first step, don't worry about being neat. All you've got to do is to make sure that you cover all the skin. So don't worry about other details just yet. But as you apply it, you might still see a little bit of that undercoat showing through. And if you do, don't worry about it. I'll just let that first coat dry, then apply a second thin coat in exactly the same way. Because applying multiple thin coats like this ensures all the detail stays nice and sharp. Once you finish base coating the skin, you're then ready to shade it, and the colour we need for this is Reichlam Flesh Shade. I'm going to be applying it using a medium shade brush, again a good sized brush for this sort of detail, and what you want to do is get some of this paint and once more put it onto your palette. This is to control exactly how much of this you're applying at once, because you don't want to overdo it. You just want a fair amount loaded on your brush before you start to apply it, and what you do is just paint this directly onto the skin, and you'll see it runs immediately into the recessed detail and really gives the flesh some depth. So what you need to do now is carry on doing this all over the skin, and then give it about 20 minutes to dry. The shade is now completely dry, and you can see it's had a really nice effect on that skin, marking all that detail nice and clearly. And with that done, we're now ready to start brightening that skin up and highlighting it too. First of all, we're going to be applying a layer of Cadian Flesh Tone, and this I'm going to be applying mostly with a medium layer brush, but it's a good idea to have a small layer brush on hand for the finer details, especially around the face. Now this time when you use the palette, what you need to do is make sure you haven't overloaded your brush. Still add some water to the mix so the paint is nice and smooth and flowing really easily, kind of like this, and then just use the palette just to twist your brush like this to get rid of the excess paint so you've got a good tip on the brush and so lots of control. And what you're looking to do is to paint this over the skin, but to avoid the areas where the shade settled the most. So for example, on the chest we just got here, on his belly, what I'm going to do is apply it to this flatter area here, and on the raised part of the scar as well, still leaving those darker bits showing in the recesses where the shade settled just there. So what you need to do now is carry on doing this all across the skin. Once you've finished applying that layer, you're then ready to highlight all the skin using Kislev Flesh. Now this time we're going to use a small layer brush to apply it, because we want to be even more focused than we were previously with Cadian Flesh Tone. Again, use your palette to get your paint ready by thinning it down, and this time you really must make sure you've got that fine tip in your brush, because really what we're looking to do here is paint lines now. So once the paint is flowing like that, you're ready to start picking out these features. And what we're looking for are the most prominent things. So the face is a great example here. What you look to do is really follow the bone structure on the face. You want to follow things like the bridge of the nose just down there like that, and then the brows just going across there. You want to get the cheekbones as well. So things like that, just to see, you're really making all the features start to pop out by doing this. Now on the muscles, because they're a bit smoother, what you need to do is aim for the crest of the muscle. So you're looking at areas such as just along there like that. And as you encounter scars, be sure to go around them as well. Now the skin's highlighted, we need to pick out all the scars, and to do this all you need is Karaberg Crimson. Now this shade is going to be a little bit different how we apply it. We need a small layer brush once more to do it, because we need to be careful and focus it just on the scars. So use your palette to make sure your brush isn't overloaded, and there's two sorts of scars you'll get on these miniatures. There's one that's etched into the skin, and we've got one of these just on top of the arm here. In this case, what you do is just paint the shade directly into them as neatly as you can, like that. As the ones that are raised and healed, like the one we've got here, for these ones, just paint it entirely over them. So you want the shade to go over the top of them and settle on either side to give them a pinkish tinge. Now that we've finished painting that skin, we're ready to start blocking in some of the other colours on the miniature. And the first colour we're going to apply is called Balthazar Gold. Now this is going to be for all the brass details. So you're looking at things like trim and cornate icons. And to apply it, I'm mostly going to be using my medium layer brush. But some of these details are very small, so having a small layer brush on hand is a good idea for this part. But as before, you just need to use your palette to get your paint ready. So thin down with a small amount of water and don't overload your brush. And when you're ready, you just need to start picking out these details. Now, during this stage, you don't have to worry about being all that neat as you apply this colour, because we are going to be applying other base colours to neaten up as we go. The only time to be neat is when you get close to the skin. So, for example, just down here near the foot, just be careful when you're getting close to the skin so that you don't get any of this colour on those details. And you will need two thin coats with this colour. With all those brass details now base coated in, we're ready to move on to applying some other base colours. And the first of these is going to be corn red for all the red details. So things like his armour, his tongue, and there's a small detail on his top knot as well. And then we're going to be moving on to lead belcher for all the silver. So this will be the axe blade and the chains. Then we'll be using Mechanicus Standard Grey for his trousers, followed by Mournfang Brown for all the leather strapping. Finally, we need a Abaddon Black, and this is going to be for all of his hair. So starting out then, first of all, using corn red, I'm going to be using a medium layer brush again mostly, but with a small layer brush on hand, and what we want to do here is just block in all these details, but now being much neater than we were previously. So as always, you just water the thin the paint down a little bit so it's got more control, and when you're ready you just need to start applying this as carefully as you can. So you can see what I'm going to do here on this panel on the leg is just working these parts in between the trim, just going up to the trim but not onto it there like that, being really neat around those parts, then just a bit quicker on the flatter parts in the middle. Now you also remember to pick out the tongue, for which you just need to be really neat. And as well as that, you just want to paint the small bit of leather that we've got on the top knot, which is just here. The next colour to apply is lead belcher for all the silver details. So for this one, you're looking at things like the chains down here, but also, of course, the axe blade. And whilst you're doing this, just be really careful of the bronze as you're applying this colour. The next colour to apply is Mechanicus Standard Grey, and this is for the trousers. And as you're applying this, just remember, be really neat as you get close to those other colours before you move on to the next step. Now that we've neatened up that Mechanicus Standard Grey on the trousers, we're ready to apply Mournfang Brown, and this is for all the leather straps and belts. And finally, paint all of the hair with Abaddon Black. Now at this point, with the other miniatures in the warband, you'll also need to paint their boots as well. Now that we've finished blocking in all those base colours, we need to shade them, and for this we can do all of them at the same time using Agraxer Shade. Now I'm going to be applying this using my medium layer brush once more, and what we need to do here is just be careful not to apply too much at once, because you don't want to get this onto the skin, you see. So use your palette to control exactly how much you have on your brush, and when you're ready, all you've got to do is start painting this onto these new base colours. So I'm going to start just around here, being quite quick as I go to these more open areas, but when you get close to the skin, you can see I'm just really careful just to get a nice neat line across areas like that. So what you need to do now is just carry on applying this shade, and once you've done so, give the model about 20 minutes to dry. The shade is now completely dry and given all those details lots of depth, but it has also dulled down the red quite a bit, so what we need to do now is just brighten it up a little bit before we move on to highlighting. So to do this, we're going to go back to corn red and reapply it, only slightly differently this time. What we're looking to do is to paint over most of the areas that are red, only to avoid the recessed parts with the shade settled. So it's like when we're layering the skin, really. So as always, thin your paint down so it's nice and smooth. And once you're ready, what you're looking to do is to, well, if you apply it to this leg piece here, this is a great example. What we're looking to do is to apply it to the flatter parts in the middle, but not go quite to the corners where it meets the brass. So this way, we keep that depth of the shading, but we also get a brighter finish. With that red reapplied, we're now ready to begin highlighting all the details. And the first detail we're going to highlight is all that brass trim. Now for this, the colour we need is Psychorax Bronze. And we're going to be applying it using a small layer brush, because the technique here is called edge highlighting. And to do it, you need lots of control over where you're applying the paint. So be sure to thin your paint down and make sure your brush isn't overloaded. What you really need is that fine tip on your brush. So just use the palette to achieve that. And when you're ready, what you're looking to do is to paint a line of this colour following along all the sharpest details. So if we look at this knee just here, what I'm looking to do is to follow along the corner there. You can see I'm just using the side of my brush to do this one, just because that corner is so sharp. Just running along there and just there. But sometimes you just need to hold your hand steady and follow along as neatly as you can, like this. So what you need to do now is just carry on going around all the brass trim doing this. I've finished highlighting all the brass details, and you can see they're all jumping out nicely now and look really good. And what we need to do is carry on doing this and all the remaining colours that we blocked in earlier. So first of all, we're going to highlight all the silver parts using Stormhost Silver, so the axe and the chains and things. And then we're going to move on to using Evilson Scarlet to highlight all the red armour. Now after this, we'll need Scrag Brown to highlight all the brown leather, and then we'll need Eshin Grey to highlight the black details for all the hair. Then we're going to use Dawnstone, and this will be for the trousers, but also the hair as well, just to take that a little bit further. But we need to start out with Stormhost Silver, which I'm going to be applying still with a small layer brush. And the technique here is, well, pretty much the same as what we were doing with Cycorex Bronze a moment ago. Make sure your paint's thinned down nicely and that you've got that good tip on your brush. And when you're ready, you just want to follow all the sharpest edges of all the silver details. So if I start on the axe, really good way to paint this is, again, use the side of your brush just to run along the sharp edges like that. And this way you can get a nice, neat highlight really quickly. The next colour we need is Evil Sun Scarlet, and this is to highlight all the red armour details. So you're looking at picking out things like the ridge just down the centre of these armour panels, just like this. And whilst you're doing this colour, also be sure to pick out the highlights on this little band we've got here up on the top knot. With all that armour highlighted, we can now move on to applying Scrag Brown, and this is for all the leather details. So you just want to follow along the edges of them once again as neatly as possible. Now that all the leather's complete, we can move on to highlighting the hair. For this, we need Eschen Grey, and again, follow the most raised details. So this means just follow the strands all the way down. And finally, we need Dawnstone, and this is for two details. First of all, the trousers, where you're looking to pick out the creases. So for example, we've got one just down here, just a fine line, following it down there like that. As for the hair, we want a very fine highlight here. And what you're looking to do is to look for areas where the light would catch. So for example, just this crest running along there, just a fine highlight to pick that detail out there. Like that. And with those highlights applied, at this point, most of your warband will be ready to be based. But this particular miniature is a little bit different because Garrick's holding a severed head, so we need to paint that in now before we do his base. Now we're going to go for a slightly paler skin tone here than what we did on the rest of Garrick. So this time we're going to start out by base coating the skin with Cadian Flesh Tone, and then we'll shade over it with Reichland Flesh Shade. After that, we'll add a layer of Kislev Flesh, and then we'll highlight it with Flayed One Flesh. Then we need to paint in the hair. Now for this we'll start out with Gorthor Brown first of all, then shade it with Agrax Earthshade, and then pick out the strands using Baneblade Brown. Finally, we're going to add some blood for the Blood God for the neck stump, of course, and some on the axe as well, because he has just cut that head off. But we need to start out with Cadian Flesh Tone, which we're going to be applying with the medium layer brush once more. And what we're looking to do here is get a good solid base coat to start working from with all the rest of the colours. So, as always, thin your paint down, but when you apply it, you do need a strong finish here, so you will need to apply two thin coats. With that base coat done, you're now ready to use Reichland Flesh Shade, and you want to paint this all over the flesh of the severed head. Once that shade's completely dry, you're now ready to apply a layer of Kislev Flesh using a small layer brush. And you want to paint most of the skin here, just avoiding the recessed detail where that shade settled most. And finally, apply a highlighter Flayed One Flesh just to pick out the most defined features of the face. The next colour we need is Gorthor Brown, and this is for all the hair just here. Now be careful as you apply it, especially in between the fingers. Next we need Agrax Earthshade to apply over the hair. And again, be careful as you're applying this, especially when you're getting here between the finger and thumb. And once that shade is dry, you're ready to highlight the hair using Baneblade Brown. And for this, what you want to do is just paint some vertical lines just running down the strands. And finally, add some blood for the Blood God to the head. Now, mostly it's a good idea to apply it around the neck stump, just around here. But I'm going to add some trickling out the mouth too. But another good place to put it is on the axe blade. Now, for this, what I recommend you do is make sure your brush isn't overloaded and start applying it in a flicking motion going up the blade like this. Because this way you get a really cool blood spray effect building up. With that head done, we're now ready to paint the base of the miniature. To do this, the first step is going to be to apply Mechanicus Standard Grey to it to neaten it up and prepare it for the next stage, which is then to paint in all the dirt using Rhinox Hide. After this, we're going to shade over all the texture using Agrax Earthshade to really bring it out and give it some depth. But first of all, we need Mechanicus Standard Grey, which I'm going to be applying with a medium base brush this time. And this first stage is really, as I say, just to neaten it up. So use a little bit of water to thin your paint down, as usual. And when you're ready, what we're looking to do is to, if you look around this foot here, you can see some of the colour has just got onto the base there. So what I'm looking to do is to just neaten up things like that. With that done, you're then ready to start picking out all the patches of dirt using Rhinox Hide. And you're looking for areas such as this and apply the paint quite roughly for a more natural appearance. And then apply a good coat of Agrax Earthshade all over the texture of the base. With that shade dry, we now need to highlight the base, and for doing this we're going to use a technique called dry brushing, and the colours we'll need are Dawnstone followed by Screaming Skull. Now, to do dry brushing, what you need is an appropriate brush. A small dry brush is perfect for this, and you just get a small amount of paint on the tip of the bristles like that, then get some tissue and use this to start working the paint into the bristles like that. And you want to remove most of the paint from your brush before you start to apply it to the miniature, because what you want to do is gradually build up the colour with it. What you do is just start running it back and forth across the grey parts of the base. So, like here, for example, just start rubbing it like this, and you'll see that paint starts to catch on the raised areas and the edges to give a nice highlight really quickly. So what you need to do now is just carry on doing this on all the grey parts of the base. And then we want to apply a second dry brush, this time Screaming Skull, and very lightly this time, but not only on the grey, you also want to catch the brown texture as well. With all that texture picked out, we just have one more detail left to paint on the miniature, and that's, well, it's all the bones. So for this, we're going to start out with a base coat of Zandri Dust to pick out all those skulls, and then we'll shade over them with Agrax Earthshade. After that, we'll apply a layer of a Shabdi Bone to start to brighten them up, and we'll pick out his teeth at the same time there. Then we'll finish off with Screaming Skull. Finally, if you want to, you can add some more blood for the Blood God to the miniature, but that, of course, is up to you. And we need to start out with Zandri Dust for all the skulls. So I'm going to be applying this using my medium layer brush, and again, use the palette to get your paint ready. So thin down nice and smooth before you start to apply it. Now, you want to pick out all the skulls over here, and there are quite a lot. I'm going to start on this one that we've got strapped to the waist here, like this. So you just need to be as neat as you can, close to all that leather, and apply two thin coats. But remember to get all the skulls, because there are quite a lot on the base there. Next, apply Agrax Earthshade all over the skulls. And remember, don't apply too much at once, because you don't want to lose control of it. Once the shade's completely dry, you're ready to apply a layer of a Shabdi Bone. On the skulls, you want to avoid all the recessed details, picking out all the features. So just being really neat and careful like this. Now, at this stage, you also want to paint his teeth. And when you do that, you just need to hold the model as steady as you can and really take your time in picking them out. And then highlight all the skulls using Screaming Skull. And what you want to do here is just go around the sharpest features. So you look at things like going around the eye sockets like this, around the cheekbones, the top of the nose, all these kind of features. And then as a final detail, I'm just going to add a few patches of blood for the Blood God onto the base. Just small areas like this. And with that done, we then just need to paint the edge of the base. Now for this one, I'm going to use a Baddam Black. And with that done, the model is complete. And with that, Garak Gorebeard is complete, ready to cause carnage and take skulls for corn on the streets of Shadespire. So when you're painting these miniatures, we recommend that you start out with their skin. It's the biggest feature of them, and if you do a good job on it, then you'll get a fantastic final result on your miniature. Later on, when you're applying shade to smaller details, just remember to be careful not to apply too much shade at once so that you don't lose control of it and get it onto details that you've finished. And finally, when you're applying highlights to the miniature, just remember to take your time and be as neat as you can. So we hope you've enjoyed this video and learned something from it, and have fun painting Garak's Reavers, and we'll see you all again soon.